the day, just on the stand with the lady. She might be about to do it. That's fine. Namaste Sarasati Devi, Gauravani Pricharine, Nirvishesha Shunyavari Paschacha Desatarine. Vancha Kaupata Rubhyasya Kripa Sindhu Bhaivata Patitanam Pavane Yo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasari Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So today is the disappearance day of first Gadadhar Pandit and then Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So we will speak something first about Gadadhar Pandit, and then we'll speak about Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So Gadadhar Pandit was born in Mayapur, at his home, very near to the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those of you who go to Mayapur may know, when you go, when you come to the yoga peak, on the way there, there's a Shiva Sangam. Well, this is after the yoga peak, there's Shiva Sangam. Then after that, then there's two houses. One house is Advaita Acharya's house, because Advaita also has a house in Shantipur. But he had one house in Mayapur, and the other is the house of Gadadhar.
Advaita Acharya
has two houses.
Advaita Acharya, 他有两间房子, 有一间是在 Shantipur的, 另一间就是在哪里?
So, Gadadhar grew up with Lord Chaitanya. They were about the same age, and they went to school, the same school.
So, Gadadhar Pandit, 他跟 Chaitanya 不是一起长大的，他们去 同一家学校。
So they were intimate friends, and Gadadhar was very, very intimately attached to Lord Chaitanya.
他们是非常亲密的朋友，表达他也是非常依附于主宰他呀。
In the beginning, Lord Chaitanya was playing the pastimes of being a great scholar, and he was a great logician, and he would make fun of the devotees.
那在开始的时候，主宰他呀是扮演一个哲学者的角色，在他的逍遥时光里面。
And he would always argue with them about logic and different conclusions and from the scriptures, and he would always defeat them.
那他们常常会讲一些关于逻辑的笑话，也在经典里面找一些事情出来，他们会互相打败对方，或者是取笑对方。
And the devotees were always thinking, oh, if this Nimai Pandit, if he would become a devotee, he would be so wonderful, he could be such a wonderful creature.
那奉献者常常会说，如果尼麦潘德他成为一位奉献者的话，他一定会是一位非常好的奉献者，非常好的传教士。
Just like sometimes we meet people and we think, oh, you know, this person materially is so qualified. If he was a devotee of Krishna, then his life would be perfect.
那就像我们常常会遇到一些人，我们觉得他的物质的资格是很好的。如果他能够成为奉献者服务Krishna的话，就他的生命更变得完美了。So
Gadadhar was, and many other devotees in Mayapur were thinking like that about Lord Chaitanya.
所以格达他跟其他在麦尔的奉献者也是这样降逐彩塔雅的。
And then, after Lord Chaitanya's father died, then Lord Chaitanya went to Gaya, and it was at that time he was initiated.
那主彩塔的父亲过世以后，他就去到盖亚这个地方，也是他得到启迪的地方。
And after his initiation, then he was transformed into a devotee.
那他得到启迪以后，他转变成为一位奉献者了。And
when he came back to Mayapur, then they brought all the devotees together to meet Lord Chaitanya, and they were amazed to see Lord Chaitanya in so much ecstasy.
当他回到玛雅谷以后，所有的奉献者聚在一起去看他，他们都很惊讶看到主彩他俩在狂喜当中。
And they were, it was a wonderful transformation that Lord Chaitanya had given up being a scholar and instead he became a great devotee, a great lover of Krishna.
这是多么美妙的转变，主彩他俩他放弃了成为一位学者。 但是他现在成为了一位奉献者，是去爱 Krishna 的人。
So Vidarbha was regularly with him, and when they would go, when Lord Chaitanya would go to Sri Vasthakur's home for kirtan, then Vidarbha would also be there.
格达塔是经常跟主彩塔雅一起的，比如说他们去Sri Vasthakur的家kirtan的时候，格达塔也常常陪伴着主彩塔雅。
Vidarbha didn't like to leave Lord Chaitanya for a moment.
格达塔他并不喜欢，就算离开主彩塔雅，一刻也不喜欢。
One time, Lord Chaitanya was feeling the separation from Krishna, and he was asking, "Where is Krishna? Where is he?"
有一次，主彩塔雅感到跟 Krishna 的分离之情，他在问，主 Krishna 在哪里？他在哪里？
So they said, "Well, he's in your heart. Krishna's in your heart."
然后他说，Krishna 就在你的心里面呢。
So Lord Chaitanya thought, "What? He's in my heart?" He began to rip and claw his skin to pull up. He wanted to bring out Krishna. He wanted to find Krishna.
那主彩他也说什么？他就在我的内心嘛。他就开始去抓自己的皮肤，想要抓开他的胸膛，去把 Krishna 拿出来。
If he's in my heart, I want to get him. I want to bring him out. I want to get him.
如果他在我的内心的话，我就要把他拿出来。我要把他，我要得到他。
Devotees were shocked. They saw Lord Chaitanya was ripping at his skin. Mother Sachi was shocked. What to do?
那奉献者他们都很害怕。Sachi母亲她看到她的儿子在抓自己的胸膛，她感到很害怕，不知道怎么做。
But Gadadhar was there, and Gadadhar came to him and pacified him. Told, "It's all right. It's all right. Krishna's coming very soon. You don't need to do this. Just wait. Krishna's coming just now."
那嘎达达也在场，他去在主彩他娘的面前去安慰他，跟他说，可以的，主，Krishna 他很快就要来到，你不需要这样做。So
Mother Sachi was appreciating how this Gadadhar Pandit was so nice that he was taking so much care for Lord Chaitanya.
那萨奇妈妈她是非常欣赏，嘎达达潘德，她是多么的用心去照顾主彩他娘。
So then, of course, Lord Chaitanya took sannyas and he's going to leave Mayapur.
那当然最后，主彩他娘他成为了sannyas，要离开Mayapur。
Oh, but before that happened, first of all, there was the pastime concerning Gadadhara when Pundarik Vidyanidhi came to Mayapur.
那在之前也有一个逍遥时光是跟表达他潘也是有关的。
Pundarik Vidyanidhi came from what is now Bangladesh.
那Punavika Vidyani它是来自现在的Bangladesh的地方，孟加拉。
And we have our ISKCON center there now.
现在我们在那里有一个ISKCON的庙。
Yeah, they gave the land and the temple, they donated it all to ISKCON.
他们把这些地跟房子都捐了给ISKCON。
Yeah, they have, because Punderik was a landowner. He owned a lot of land, a lot of property, and so that place is called Punderik Dam.
那因为Punderik是一个大地主，是有很多的地的，那个地方甚至是被称为 Punderik Dam.
You can go there if you go to Bangladesh. There's many wonderful temples, many devotees.
如果你去到孟加拉这个地方，你会看到很多美妙的庙，还有很多很好的奉献者。
And the many of them are there in this Punderik Dam. There's many devotees there.
在Punderik Dam这个地方是有很多奉献者。
So Punderik came to Mayapur, and Lord Chaitanya was very, very pleased.
所以呢，Punderik来到Mayapur，主宰他也感到很受取悦。
So Gadarha was told by Mukunda, the one of Lord Chaitanya's devotees, Mukunda told Gadarha, a great devotee has come. You must come and see him.
那穆昆达就是主宰他的其中一位奉献者，他跟Gadarha说，有一位很伟大的奉献者来到了，你必须要去看看他。And
Gadarha, he was a brahmachari.
Gadarha他是一位brahmachari.
He was lifetime renounced, very austere.
他一生也是非常的气绝，非常的刻苦。
My vicharu. Where is he? Upstairs. He came from Overwatch. Anyway, so he was a brahmachari, and Mukunda told him, "This, you must come and see this great devotee." So Gadarha came, and he saw Punderik Vijayanidhi.
那所以因为穆昆达跟他说，你必须要来看这位伟大的奉献者，所以表达他来到，他看到Punderik Vijayanidhi。
But when he saw Punderik Vijayanidhi, he was surprised because he thought this Punderik Vijayanidhi is materialistic
person。但是他看到这位Punderik Vijayanidhi的时候，他有点惊讶，因为他觉得他好像一个物质主义的人。
Because he had, you know, he was sitting on a big seat and he had different drinks and different sweets and things in front of him.
因为他坐在一个很大很好的座位上面，他前面有很多不同种类的糖果啊、饮品等等。
He had some coconut to drink and he had some sherbet and he had some lemon juice and many different things.
他们的饮料，比如说椰子，什么柠檬啊，等等。
And people were fanning him on either side.
有些人跟他搭讪。
He was, you know, dressed in very nice clothes, and his hair was all very nice, you know, all set.
那他穿着一些很好的衣服，他的头发也是梳理的很好，这样。
Rings on the finger, all the fingers, and chains around the neck.
手上有很多的戒指，脖子上也有很多的链。
And Gadarha's a brahmachari. He's there in his old cloth, you know, and he's looking at this person. He thinks, he is a great devotee. He doesn't look like a great devotee.
Gadarha判断他是一位 brahmachari, 穿着一些破旧的衣服。那他看到这个人的时候，他觉得。 他是真的是一位伟大的奉献者吗? 看起来好像不像。
So Gadarha was thinking, this is person, he is not so great.
所以Gadarha他在想，那这个人不像是一个很好的奉献者。
So Mukunda could understand something that Gadarha is looking with his material eyes.
那穆昆达他明白了，因为达达他是以物质的角度去看。So
Mukunda began to sing a verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
穆昆达就开始唱诵了《博迦瓦坛》里面的一个四节。
There's a famous verse which is sung about how merciful Lord Krishna is.
那这是一个很有名的诗节，是关于Krishna是多有多仁慈。
That he accepted Putana as his nurse.
因为他接受了Putana作为他的护士。
Although she came with poison on her breast to feed poison to Krishna, Krishna accepted her as his mother.
虽然他在胸上面涂上一些毒药，但是Krishna还是接受他成为他的母亲。
Like this, Baki, the sister of Baki, Bakasura was the one demon also killed by Krishna. So Putana was the sister of Baki.
那巴卡苏瓦也是以Krishna杀掉的其中一个恶魔，那阿布塔呢就是这个巴卡苏瓦的姐妹。And
they both had come trying to kill Krishna.
他们两个也是尝试去杀Krishna.
But Putana came offering her breast to Krishna.
但是Krishna，但是布塔呢，他来到是把自己的乳房供奉给Krishna.
So Krishna accepted her as his nurse.
所以Krishna是接受了他成为他的护士,
and brought her back to Godhead.
把他带回守神。
So when he sang this verse, then Pundarik Vijayanidhi became stunned. Baba, his love for Krishna was awakened, and he fell off his seat, and he knocked over everything, and he rolled on the ground back and forth, shedding tears, and all the ground became flooded with the water coming from his eyes.
那这个Punarik他听到这个师姐以后，他突然呆住了，然后从这个座位上面跳出来，把所有的东西都扫在地上，然后他开始哭泣，在地上滚动，然后他的眼泪就把这个地都弄湿了。And
he was rolling back, screaming and crying in ecstasy for several hours.
那在地上滚来滚去，在尖叫，在哭泣，这种的状态维持了几个小时。
So Gadarhar was shocked. He saw, oh, he's a great devotee.
那Gadarhar他非常惊讶，他说，哦，他果然是一个伟大的奉献者。
So Gadarhar felt very bad, you know, I'm offending a great devotee.
那Gadarhar他感觉不好，因为他觉得自己冒犯了一位伟大的奉献者。
So he thought, what to do? So he decided that I should accept him as my spiritual master. So Gadarhar went to Lord Chaitanya and he asked Lord Chaitanya for permission. I want to take initiation from this Pundarik Vijayanidhi.
那Gadarhar他来到主宰他面前去问他的允许，说我想。 我想向这个Pundarik他去哪里得到启迪。
So Lord Chaitanya said, oh, very nice, yes, go ahead.
主宰他也说非常好啊，去吧。
So he asked Pundarik Vijayanidhi that you please accept me as your disciple.
那所以他来到Pundarik Vijayanidhi他的面前，跟他说，请你接受我成为你的门徒吧。
So on an auspicious day, Pundarik Vijayanidhi initiated Gadarhar Pandit.
所以在一个吉祥的日子，Pundarik Vijayanidhi就去启迪了Gadarhar
Pandit。 那Pundarik Vijayanidhi, he was also a That he is actually not different from the father of Radharani.
那事实上，他是跟Radharani的父亲是没有区别的。
Who is the mother and father of Radharani?
Radharani的父母是谁了？
Kirtidan Vrishabham, right? So just this Punarik Vijati Nidhi is not different from Maharaj Vrishabham. You came to take part in the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And of course, Gadarhar is expansion of Srimati Radharani. So we were saying Lord Chaitanya went off and took sannyas. And when he took sannyas, then also Gadadhar was there. And when Lord Chaitanya went to Jagannath Puri, Gadadhar also went to Jagannath Puri. And while Gadadhar was in Jagannath Puri, Lord Chaitanya discovered a deity. Lord Chaitanya began digging the ground, and from out of the ground, he uncovered a deity.
那他开始去挖地，在地里面，他发现了一个神像。A
deity, so Krishna.
这是一个 Krishna 的神像。
And so he told Gadadhar, you should worship this deity.
所以他跟 Gadadhar说, 你应该去崇拜这个神像。
This deity is known as Totagopinath.
这个神像的名字就是 Totagopinath.
So Gadadhar was given the service that you should worship this deity.
So Gadadhar他接受了这个服务，就是要去崇拜这个神像。
And Gadadhar vowed that he would stay there in Jagannath Puri and serve the deity.
So Gadadhar他发誓了会留在Jagannath Puri去服务这个神像。
He took a vow which is called Kshetra Sannyas.
他发这个誓愿就是叫做 Kshetra Sannyas.
Kshetra means, no, Jagannath Puri is Kshetra. That's known as Kshetra. It's the place, huh? The holy place.
那Kshetra这个字就是，比如说 Jagannath Puri，就是一个神圣的地方。
So Gadadhar vowed that he would never leave there.
Gadadhar他发誓了，他永远不会离开。
Some people make that kind of vows, Kshetra Sannyas, that they will stay in the holy place. They will never leave.
有些人他们也会发这样的誓，就是他们会留在圣地，不会离开。So
Gadadhar was there in Jagannath Puri, but then Lord Chaitanya decided he was going to leave Jagannath Puri.
所以Gadadhar他就要留在Jagannath Puri了，但是主Chaitanya他确定了要离开Jagannath Puri。
Lord Chaitanya wanted to go and visit many places. He wanted to go to Vrindavan and go to South India.
那朱塞坦也他希望去很多不同地方，比如说宾达本、南印度等等。
So then Gadadhar said, I also will go with you.
那所以Gadadhar说，我也想要跟你去。
But Lord Chaitanya said, oh no.
但是朱塞坦也说不行。
You've got Gopinath here, you have to serve Gopinath.
因为你有了Totagopinath在这里，你必须要服务他。
But Gadadhar said, you're not different.
但是Gadadhar他说，你跟Gopinath没有区别。我希望要服务你的莲花主。But
Lord Chaitanya did not agree. He said, no, you have made the vow. You should stay here in Jagannath Puri.
但是朱塞坦也不同意，他说，因为你发了这个誓，你必须要留在Jagannath Puri.
But Gadadhar said, but to hell with my vow. He said, I just want to serve you, Lord Shri.
但是Gadadhar他说，我的誓愿下地狱吧，我反正就是要服务你的莲花主。
Well, Lord Chaitanya was not pleased. They said, no, you have made the vow. You should keep your vow.
但是主Chaitanya很不高兴，他说，因为你发了誓，所以你必须要保持你的誓愿。
So, Lord Chaitanya would not allow Gadadhar to come with them. Gadadhar said, Papa, I'll go on my own. You go ahead, I'm going on my own. Lord Chaitanya was walking and Gadara was following behind some distance behind.
那所以主宰他开始在走动，那Gadara就在他不远处跟着他。
Gadara did not want to give up Lord Chaitanya. But finally, Lord Chaitanya got in a boat and he told Gadara, now you go back.
那但是最后呢，主宰他的他上了一艘船，然后他跟Gadara说，你回去吧。
And Gadara fainted.
那Gadara就昏倒了。
Could not tolerate the separation of Lord Chaitanya.
他不能忍受跟主宰他的分离。
So Lord Chaitanya was also showing that he expects devotees to be very steady in their service. He did not like people to be whimsical, to take up doing something and then give it up and then go and do something else. He liked to see people steady in their service.
那他们不希望那些人做一些事情，然后突然之间放弃。他希望他们都是很平稳的前进。So
Lord Chaitanya was instructing all of us through his teaching to Gadara Pandit.
所以主宰他也是通过他对Gadara Pandit的教导，也是教导我们。
It's very important to be steady in our service.
那在我们的服务里面变得平稳是非常重要的。So
Lord Chaitanya, after his travels, of course, he came back to Jagannath Puri and he spent many hours in the association of Gadara
Pandit.
Here, Lord Chaitanya would like to hear the Srimad Bhagavatam from the mouth of Gadara Pandit.
主宰他也很希望从Gadara Pandit的口中听到对国家瓦坛的讲述。The
Gadara Pandit would regularly recite all the Srimad Bhagavatam. Particularly Lord Chaitanya liked to hear the pastimes of Dhruva Maharaj and Prahlad Maharaj.
Gadara Pandit他常常会去阅读所有的国家瓦坛的诗节。那主宰他也很喜欢听，特别是 Dhruva Maharaj 跟 Prahlad Maharaj 的逍遥时光。
These were the two sections Lord Chaitanya would hear again and again from the Srimad Bhagavatam.
这国家瓦坛的两部分，就是主宰他也很喜欢听完再听的。And
Gadara Pandit would be reading, but Gadara Pandit, when he would be reading Srimad Bhagavatam, so many tears would come from his eyes. And of course, the tears coming from his eyes would sometimes smudge the ink with the writing of the Srimad Bhagavatam.
那这些眼泪就是会把这本书的墨水都化开。Became
difficult for him to read the Srimad Bhagavatam.
所以他在阅读这本国家瓦坛的时候就很困难了。So,
Gadara Pandit, such a great devotee, he could read the Srimad Bhagavatam. Lord Chaitanya would relish hearing the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam.
表达他是一位多么的伟大的奉献者，主宰他也很喜欢从他那里去听到国家瓦坛的诗节。And
as he got older, Gadara was still worshipping the deity of Gopinath. But the deity was quite big. And, you know, when you serve the deity, you have to stretch out all the time. It became difficult for him to serve the deity.
所以他变老的时候，他仍然是在服务这个Gopinath的神像，但是因为这个神像是都挺大的，所以他服务他的时候要把手伸上去，对他来讲有一点困难。So
the deity understood Gadara, the difficulty of Gadara Pandit. Then you will see the deity today is sitting.
这个神像明白了Gadara Pandit的难处，所以你会看到这个神像，它是坐着的。The
deity was originally standing, but to allow the devotee to serve him easier, the deity sent come.
那本来这个神像是站着的，但是为了让奉献者可以更容易的服务他，他就是坐下来了。
So the deity is still being worshipped today by the disciples of the disciples in that line coming from the darker planet.
所以这个神像直到今天也是由来自Gadarpanda的门徒的师徒传承的门徒来崇拜。
So these are just some pastimes of Gadarpanda.
所以刚才讲述了一些关于Gadarpanda的逍遥时光。
So of course today is also the disappearance day of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
今天也是Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur的隐居日。
Srila Prabhupada describes Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur as being the pioneer of spreading Krishna consciousness in the Western world.
那Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur就是把 Krishna 直接传播到西方的先锋。
In the year 1896, which is the year of Prabhupada's birth, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was sending books to universities and colleges in America and Canada.
那1896年就是圣巴布巴出生的那一年，Bhaktivinoda Thakur他把一些书去寄到一些加拿大跟美国的大学。
I was reading the memories of one of the first devotees. There's one devotee called Govinda Devi Dasi, and she wrote her memories, and she was describing how her husband and another devotee had gone into the university in Montreal. And they were in the library in Montreal, and they found the book by Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
那我在阅读一些早期的奉献者他们写的一些回忆，那有一位奉献者，他的名字叫做Govinda Devi Dasi，他写了他跟他的丈夫去了蒙特这个地方的一所大学里面，他们在图书馆里面找到了一本Bhaktivinoda Thakur的书。And
they told Prabhupada, and when Prabhupada heard, and Prabhupada said, "Yes, very good," he said, "This is proof how much Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted this message of Lord Chaitanya to be spread."
他们告诉帕布巴很高兴，他说，这证明了Bhaktivinoda Thakur多么的希望Krishna的信息可以传播开去。
So, also interesting, a coincidence you could say, that the same year Prabhupada was born, that was when Bhaktivinoda Thakur was preaching.
那很有趣的一点就是，Bhaktivinoda Thakur他开始这样传教的那一年，就是Srila Prabhupada出生的那一年。So
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur was born in a wealthy family, and in the beginning of his life, he was very interested in Western culture, Western knowledge. He didn't take a great interest in the Vedic culture.
那Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur出生在一个很富裕的家庭。 那在他年轻的时候，他对西方的文化知识很有兴趣，但是对传统的伟达文化的兴趣就不大。But
gradually he began to see the shortcomings in the Western life, and he was looking for alternatives.
那但是慢慢的，他发现了西方的生活的缺点，然后他就慢慢去开始发现了伟达文化。
And he became interested in his own Indian culture, and he was looking at the philosophy from the different acharyas, different spiritual leaders in his own country.
那所以他开始对自己的传统文化有兴趣，他开始去看以前他们传统的灵性导师传统的知识。
And eventually he came across the writings of the Goswamis, people like Jiva Goswami, and he heard about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and the message of the Bhagavatam.
那他慢慢的发现了Jiva Goswami 还有Jiva Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 还有佛教瓦堂的信息。
And he was looking, he with great difficulty, he was able to get a copy of the Chaitanya Charitamrita. He could not find one. It was very difficult for him to find a copy.
那他找到了《荣的裁判的经》这本书，找了很久，因为对他来说是很困难才找到一本。
So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur had, after reading all of these books like the Chaitanya Charitamrita Bhagavatam, then he became very impressed that this was the highest knowledge he'd ever come across anywhere.
所以, Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur 他阅读了永恒的《裁檀》跟《佛家瓦檀》, 他就发现了这些知识就是最高的知识。
Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur then began to write books and songs. He wrote, even from a very early age in his childhood, he'd been writing.
所以Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur他开始写了很多的书，很多的歌，就算是他还是小孩子的时候，已经开始写作了。
He wrote many, many different songs. There's a big, thick book, Bengali songs, all written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
他写了很多很多的歌，有一本就是很厚的书，里面都是孟加拉语的，Bhaktivinoda Thakur写的歌。
Because Bhaktivinoda Thakur's idea was that by singing these songs, then one will think of the pastimes of Krishna and Lord Chaitanya, and one will learn also the philosophy of Krishna consciousness.
因为巴蒂比诺塔库的想法就是，如果他们唱这些歌的话，他们就会明白到主彩坦也跟主克什纳，从而也会明白到当中的哲学。Of
course, we have to understand the language. We have to know what the song is about.
当然，我们必须要明白那种语言，明白这些歌就是唱什么的。
Prabhupada said, "Don't just sing the song. You have to know what the meaning is."
嗯，还有话说，你要不仅仅去唱这些歌，也要明白它的意思。
Therefore, you see Prabhupada's purports for some of the songs.
所以我们会看到，帕瓦巴有一些歌也有下了药子。
Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote books like Sharanagati, which means surrender, and for surrender is based on six principles.
那巴蒂比诺塔库他写了一本。 歌书就是叫Saranagati，就是臣服的意思。那如果我们要臣服的话，就是要根据六个原则。Remember
those six principles?
那这六个原则是什么呢？
What's one of them? You know one of these principles about surrender?
关于臣服的其中一个原则是什么呢？
Who knows?
有人知道吗？
Huh?
Yeah, humility is one.
嗯，其中一个就是谦卑。
Come on.
Service.
What?
Service.
服务。What service?
什么服务？奉爱服务。是不是？Enthusiasm.
No.
不是。
Yeah. There are six principles. It's mentioned in the Bhagavad Gita in the purport of 1866, chapter 18, verse 66.
嗯，佛教梵歌的十八章六十六节里面就是有讲述这六个原则。
Alright, what's that verse? 1866. Sarva Dharma. Give up all religion. Surrender to me. Krishna saying, surrender to me. So what does surrender mean?
那这个世界就是放弃所有的宗教原则，只臣服于我。但是这个臣服是什么意思呢？
We talk about surrender. What does it mean?
我们常常讲到臣服，但是它真正的意思是什么？
There are six items of surrender.
臣服是有六个原则。
Devotees are supposed to know these things.
那奉献也必须要知道。
No, not amanit mamatam. That's not surrender. That's something else. Anukuyasa sankalpa, pratikuyasa vartana. First of all, you have to accept everything which is favorable for devotional service.
首先你是需要接受所有对奉爱服务有帮助的事情。
What is favorable for devotional service?
什么是对奉爱服务好的？
Prasadam.
Prasadam.
Kirtan.
Kirtan.
Hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. Associating with devotees. These things are all favorable for devotional service. And we have to give up everything which is not favorable for devotional service. What is not favorable for devotional service? Meat eating, intoxication, gambling, and illicit sex. All not favorable for devotional service.
非法的性行为、赌博等等，都是对关爱服务不好的。So
we have to give up these things.
所以我们必须要放弃这一切。We
have to know that only Krishna can protect us.
我们要明白，只有Krishna才能保护。We
don't pray to anybody else for protection.
其他人去祈祷，希望得到保护。Except
the desire for Krishna.
那我们应该不会有其他的欲望，除了对Krishna有关的欲望。
And we should always be meek and humble.
我们必须要常常恭顺跟谦卑。These
are the six items of surrender.
这就是六个臣服的原则。So
Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote songs on each of these six items.
所以 Bhaktivinoda Thakur 他对这六个的每一个都写了一首歌。
Just like we sing the one song in here. Shuddha Bhakta Charana Renu Bhajana Anukula. Right? You know this song? We've sung this song, heard before?
Yes.
Yes? Yeah. So, which item of devotional service is that about?
那刚才的那首歌是关于奉爱服务的那一个
The dust of the feet of the devotees, the water which is offered to their, the water which has washed their feet, and the remnants of their pushta are favorable for their favorable. So this is a song about things which are good, which we should accept for devotional
service.
So Bhaktivinoda Thakur wrote many songs for each of these six items of surrender. That is just one book, Saranagati, but he wrote many other books also.
And
he wrote all these different songs just to help us to be Krishna conscious.
他写这些歌都是为了让我们变得更有Krishna自己。
And if you go to Bangladesh, when you go to Bangladesh, or like there's villages in Bangladesh where people are Vaishnavas, and they sing all of these songs, they know all these songs because it's in their own language, and they sing them all the time.
如果你是孟加拉的话，有一些村庄里面的人，他们都懂唱所有的这些歌，因为都是。 来就是他们的语言的，所以他们都懂唱。
So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur led a life of intense labor, writing, preaching Krishna
consciousness。所以他的一生都是充满很多的工作的，他是写作，还有去传播Krishna自己。He
discovered the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya。他重新发现主宰他的出生地。 He established the first temple there at the Yoga
Peak.
He trained his sons to be devotees. And of course, we know from Bhaktivinoda, we have Bhaktisiddhanta
Saraswati.
Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati was brought up under the care. He was the son of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and he was trained by his father to be a preacher. Because before Bhaktivinoda Thakur, the cult, the followers of Lord Chaitanya had become degraded and nobody respected them. But it was Bhaktivinoda Thakur who re-established people's faith in Gaudiya Vaishnavas.
但是就是Bhaktivinoda Thakur他把 人们对Gaudiya Vaishnava的信心重新建立起来。
So we are very much indebted to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur for giving us so many things.
所以我们欠了巴蒂明的塔古很多，他给了我们这么多的东西。
Our Jairada Madhava song, which we think Jairada Madhava Kunja Bihari is also another song which was written by Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
就是我们每天常常在唱的 Jairada Madhava 也是来自 Bhaktivinoda Thakur的。
His deities, Bhaktivinoda Thakur worshipped the deities of Radha Madhava.
巴蒂明的 塔古他崇拜 Radha Madhava的神像。
So we are following in the footsteps of Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted us to preach, to distribute the message of Lord Chaitanya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur would preach in the villages. In his time, 100 years ago, most people lived in the villages. There was not so many factories. There were no computers, there were no software engineers, there were no Microsoft companies or like that.
没有电脑，没有一些工程师，也没有这个微软的公司等等。
And everybody was living in the villages, and they were farming, growing rice.
所有人都是住在村里面，他是农夫，会去种米等等。
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur was going to the villages and preaching.
巴蒂比诺塔库就会去这些村里面去传教。
And his system of preaching is just what we do. Then he would have kirtan, then they would have a class, and then they would distribute prasadam.
那他传教的系统也是跟我们差不多的，他会有一些 kirtan， 然后他会讲课，然后就会荣耀记录。
And Bhaktivinoda Thakur will go in this way from one village to another. He established the Namhata preaching.
那就这样，他去从一条村庄去另一条村庄，这样他建立了这个 Namhata 的系统。
So we are trying to follow in the footsteps of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
所以我们尝试去 跟随 Bhaktivinoda Thakur的步伐。
Bhaktivinoda Thakur wanted us to develop Mayapur.
他希望我们去建立 Mayapur.
And develop the Navadvipa Parikrama.
去建立 Navadvipa的绕拜。
So many even Bhaktivinoda Thakur like to also bring the important men, the government leaders and so on, to bring them to Mayapur.
他也希望我们把一些，比如说重要的政府的官员的人物带来 Mayapur.
To build the Mayapur temple, Bhaktivinoda Thakur was ready to go begging to every door in Calcutta and ask every gentleman to give 1 rupee.
那为了建立在迈阿普的庙，巴蒂比诺塔库他甚至去了加尔各答，就是跟所有的人都去讨一个卢比。So
we have to thank Bhaktivinoda Thakur for giving us this Mayapur Dham and giving us all this message of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以我们必须要去感谢巴蒂比诺塔库给了我们迈阿普的圣地，还有跟主宰他涅玛哈帕布有关的信息。
We offer our obeisances to Bhaktivinoda Thakur. We say Namo Bhaktivinodaya Satchidananda Namini Gora Shakti Swarupaya Rupa Nuga Varahiti. But we offer our respectful obeisances to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, who possesses the energy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
那所以刚才的祷文就是我们向巴蒂比诺塔库去顶拜，他是拥有主宰他耶马哈帕布的力量。And
he's a direct follower of Srila Rupa Goswami.
他是 Srila Rupa Goswami 直接的跟随者。So
today we're observing his disappearance day.
所以我们今天是庆就是庆祝他的 Giri.
So Giri Hari Swami will be coming 11 o'clock.
Giri Hari Maharaj 11点会来到.
So we'll be having more kirtan.
有更多的kirtan.
And we'll hear more about Bhakti Vinod Thakur.
也会听更多关于 Bhakti Vinod Thakur 的逍遥时光.
Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur ki.
Jai.